Hello, everyone, and welcome back to No Man's Sky. We're about to leave this rock because it's junk. I mean, it does have gravitino balls, and I'm tempted to roam around and maybe even possibly go to a bunch of different ruins and pick up stuff there, but it is a toxic world, so also no. I'm tempted to just nope my way out of this. So one thing I noticed in between episodes here was if we go to our multi-tool here, I can install the damage buff on it. So your grenade intensity theta right there. We have aluminum, we have nickel, we have neutrino modules. Why not? We were going to do it anyway. We do need the aluminum and nickel for the additional warp drive mods, but we're going to have to get more aluminum and nickel anyway. So really, yeah, do it. And then one of these for the beam, or the bolt caster rather. Well, so let's think about this for a minute. Yeah, Boltcaster would be good. So Boltcaster is this side. We do reload accelerator, but I think instead what we want to do is one of the... if we can do damage, that'd be great. There's a damage tau. There's a damage... No, that's rapid fire theta. Stabilizer theta. Is there a damage theta? There is. We can't afford it because it requires Radnox. And I haven't even seen Radnox yet. Okay, but... But we're not going to do Rickshade because that's just silly. But we could do impact damage tau, more physical damage on impact. Yeah, we might do that. Reload accelerant and stabilizer, not really the best idea, I think. Short burst adapter, plus 5 even. Huh, if the next planet has copper, abso-freaking-lutely. Short rapid sequences of fire. That's basically how we're firing anyway. So, yeah, let's do that. Assuming, of course, that we don't end up finding another multi-tool and just, you know, just dumping everything we have right now. Let's fill it with plutonium. Go over to the exosuit and recharge what we need with some shielding shards, shielding sheets, whatever. And okay, so we have some iron. I can refuel the warp cell. Not gonna do it yet. So let's get off this rock. We don't want this rock. It's a bad rock. I mean, I hate that. I hate to tell people that, you know, they live here, but your planet sucks. I'm sorry. I mean, I realize that would sound really bad if, you know, it was my planet and they said, you know what? The planet stinks. There's not enough life on it. There's not enough resources. How the heck do you plan on, you know, reaching space? I don't know why I did that. I just did it. Do it, I suppose. Okay, so... There's at least one other planet here. I just don't know where that is. Pulsing doesn't tell me... Will it tell me? It might. So I already discovered this. I should probably... Oh, of course, another abandoned building. Because we always find abandoned buildings this way. So we should probably rename this planet just so we know we've been here. Rename and upload... I like Wreck. That's good. Wreckyard. I think like Wreckyard 2. And then go ahead and just upload these. And we didn't really encounter these guys so much. This guy was actually fearful. So was it just the one world that had things that we needed to be afraid of? That one's calm. That one's also calm. And that's the variation. Timmerman is erratic. And then passive. So yeah, it's just the one world that just had vicious life forms. Okay. Weird. Here I thought it would be endemic to all planets in the solar system, but apparently not. Oh, there we go. That's the one undiscovered. We already discovered that one. We haven't actually been to that space station yet. But okay, this is the last planet in the system. Destroy this rock, though. It might have something good in it. You never know. Iridium. Man, where was this rock, like, 6 episodes ago, you know? I would have killed for a rock full of iridium. And now I just really, I can barely bring myself to care. I mean, I suppose we still need iridium. How much iridium do we need for this hyperdrive? I mean, just build it. Say we're going to build it here. What do we do? What do we need? Okay, so we're done with iridium. We don't need any more iridium. We need nickel. We need aluminum. We need copper. Nickel aluminum. You know what? I'm going to write that down. Nickel, aluminum, copper. How much of each? We need 400 copper. So basically a slot. Okay. 600 nickel. And 800 aluminum. So more than a slot of nickel, more than a slot of aluminum. Well, actually, if it's on the ship, it's only one slot. Okay, but we have more than enough iridium. Chances are it's because a lot of the stuff's on my exosuit. Is that what's going on here? Yes, so let's go ahead and just stack that. All right, I have a power canister that I did not use. That was very silly of me. Let's recharge it with... Yeah, there we go. Didn't even recharge it completely, but good enough. So then I don't need chrysonite for anything? We're going to upgrade our multi-tool, right? We're going to add one more slot here. And we wanted to do a gun mode for that. We wanted, not wide-shot adapter, we wanted a short burst adapter. It requires 60 copper. Okay, so for that I need copper, iridium, and zinc. So like 20 of zinc, 100 iridium, 60 copper. Okay, just to make sure I don't throw away anything else, I'm gonna go back to the starship. Because then I figure I can just dump anything I don't actually want on a trader somewhere. There's a shield. Okay, yeah, the shields are only plus ones. So what makes these different? Deflection enhancement, tau, sigma, theta. But they're still only plus ones. That is just weird. I don't get it. They all protect the same thing. Laser fire, in-flight projectiles, accidentally spaced debris interaction. That's it. So why are they all plus ones? Shouldn't it do 1, 2, 3 like it was before? And why is theta over here? Shouldn't it be over on this side where tau is? I mean, I realize theta comes before tau in the Greek alphabet. But in every other technology, theta is the last one and the best one, as far as I can tell. I'm just really confused. Okay, I don't have any scanning technology either. Oh, not in the starship anyway. Yeah, nothing in the starship would obviously have that. Okay, anyway. So dynamic resonator is really the big thing. And then 200 iridium. So I definitely need... Okay, I'm going to check off the iridium. Iridium's done. Dynamic resonators, we can buy that. We have 3.2 million. I'm totally fine with buying it. We could do the pulse jet. Do we really want to? Increase maneuverability on longer burst. Or longer boost. Well, I suppose it increases or improves the Themium 9 consumption, but Themium 9 is everywhere. It's like in the 1900s, right? It's like, okay, well, this oil thing is everywhere, so who cares about oil efficiency? We can just, you know, go over and pick it up off the ground. Not exactly their mindset, but pretty much their mindset. Alright, so I don't really need the titanium or the neutrino modules because we're done doing that with the neutrino modules. Now, granted, when we upgrade again, we're going to need to do that. So what do we need to repair our warp reactor theta here? We need gold. Gold and emerald. Okay. Gold is 500, which is not checked off. Emerald is also 500. That is checked off. Okay, and it's still checking off the dynamic resonator because we have how many of these? We have two of them. Okay, so we need like six of them. No, I think we need five, huh? Yeah, we need five for the tau, or two for the tau, two for the theta, one for the sigma. Okay. Let's go ahead and dump the Themium 9 in the pulse engine. Not gonna dump anything in the hyperdrive yet. Hyperdrive, I think, has one more jump left in it. It's like 1 out of 500, though, so of course it says 0. If it doesn't let me jump, it doesn't let me jump. We can just add a warp cell. That's no big deal. And then let's go ahead and just make an electron vapor here. Oops, that's the wrong thing. Electron vapor. And then stack those and then make some antimatter. And the reason to make the antimatter is if we wanted to just make the dynamic resonator since we have the chrysonite. I think that works. Oh no, wait, what are we missing? Microdensity fabric. Well, we have the iron to do that if that's what microdensity fabric needs. We can do microdensity fabric. Now can we make a dynamic resonator? We need 4 microdensity fabrics. Okay, well, we can just stack them then. So that's 2. Let's see, that's doing platinum. Okay, we have plenty of platinum on our exosuit. No big deal. And if I don't have to buy things, I'm totally fine with just making them. So that's 3 dynamic resonators we have. Can I make... Okay, suspension fluid, electron vapor, antimatter. And then microdensity fabric. 4 of those. Oh, nope, we're out. Not enough iron. Okay, well then stack these for now. We need just a little bit more iron, then we can make another dynamic resonator. That'll take us to 4. Then what do we need? More platinum, huh? Platinum and iron. Okay, next planet should have it. Ah, here we go. Okay. Well, they're gonna stop me. I mean, I can try to jump away, but I have a feeling they're gonna stop me. I don't know, maybe I jumped away in time? We haven't been scanned. Just said the hostile ships were on approach. Did we actually get lucky enough? I stayed in space for too long, really. I was just tempting fate at that point. Okay, but the next planet is going to have iron. The question is whether or not it's going to have platinum. Probably is. That would be my guess. And then it's just a matter of whether or not it has everything else we need. So, nickel, aluminum, copper, gold, and iridium. It's likely going to have iridium. The other ones, though, that's a crapshoot. I have no idea. The other planets haven't had those. No gold in this star system whatsoever. And we should probably just go to the nearest star system. If this one doesn't have anything, we'll just jump there. But who knows? I mean, this one looks like it's going to be pretty close to the sun. I should probably drop out here. Yeah, this one's going to be pretty close to the sun. Okay, well, we'll head more or less towards it. Yeah, there we go. That was timed pretty well. Otherwise, we would have crashed into some rocks there. And only 9 seconds away. That's not too bad. So this is probably going to be an overheated world, which means we're going to require some thermal protection. No big deal. We can do that. All right. So we enter the atmosphere here. This does not have any oceans, which is not surprising this close to the sun. So maybe if this has at least one of the resources we need, we go ahead and follow the ruins like we were trying to do originally on like 2-3 episodes ago. And then see if we can actually find a portal. It'd be pretty funny to find a portal and have to leave everything behind, but I'm kind of okay with that. We are going kind of fast here. Okay, there we go. That works. What the hell is that? That's a monolith. I've been calling them monoliths. I guess that's more or less what they are. Yeah, it's totally a monolith. What direction does this go in? Well, now that's a good question. That is not clear. Can we go up, like, this way? I have no idea what these resources are. I crashed instead of landing. Okay. That's fair, I suppose. I need to just maneuver into a good position here. How about... what, over here, I guess? There's some thamium around here. It's still not going to let me land, huh? Another bump. Okay. Fine. Get down here this way? I don't know. The ground is not level at all. Here, this is kind of level. No? Not level enough for you, huh? How about, like, here? There we go. Autopilot is so picky. This is hot. Flora is lacking, but fauna is abundant. So a little bit of plant life. Let's pull, see what we got. Okay. I don't know what plant life you're referring to. Doesn't seem to exist, but okay, I'll believe you. There might be, I don't know, something here. Like that's this one lone flower here. Is that what this is? If the planet's hot, we're not hitting that yet. Yeah, this is totally. I mean, I'm going to scan it because why not? And then we have a bunch of like cacti or something. I don't know. That's interesting. No apparent sources of iron, but that spike could have been iron, I suppose. Toggle torch. I'm not sure that's going to help me right now. Yeah, I mean, it's not exactly dark. I don't know, man. This looks like the dark side of Mercury right now. It's worrying me a little bit. So, okay. I'm confused. Because supposedly, the follow the ruins, there's a line on every one of the ruins, and you follow that line to the next ruin, and the next ruin, and the next ruin, and then eventually you get to the portal. But, I guess the line lines up with this? Maybe? I mean, I don't know how else that's gonna work, but sure. I guess, I mean, otherwise there's just lines all over the place, but they're kind of supporting the ball, and I don't understand the purpose of the ball, but then again, I'm not a super advanced alien race. Well, okay then, I guess we just go up here and touch the ball and see what it gives us. It's probably just going to give us some words. I don't think it's actually going to test us at all. Or maybe it is. Dangerous-looking multi-tool that sits in their hand was not enough to save them. Surface of sculpted rock blurs and show images of military worship. It's trying to tell me something. Respect the warrior, respect his weapon. Well, so taking the multi-tool would not be respecting the weapon, I don't think.
Well, I don't know. I don't know the Viking well enough. So, in some cultures, warriors are buried with their weapons. In other cultures, warriors pass on their weapons to allies, to family, to respected warriors, to other respected warriors, and it goes down that way of, you know, this weapon helped my tutor, and now he gave it to me, and then now I'm giving it to you. Kind of like, you know, a way to pass on a weapon. So that in that case, we can just take the multi-tool and leave. But I have a feeling the Viking are the type of people that want to be buried with the tool. Yeah, that's what I'm going to go with. I mean, I don't know, so we'll find out. Okay, howl their appreciation. So yes, that was actually the correct thing to do. All right, so very Klingon of them. That's what I should have thought of. I should have thought of Klingons. I didn't actually get anything, did I? They just approved of me, health at maximum, so they were going to heal me and learn a couple words. Okay, so in the meantime, I should probably charge my exosuit here. So let's empty that out. And then what I want is to install the tech for the shield. Oh, I just need just a little bit of carbon and I can get Sigma or Tau. Tau's probably better, right? Tau's probably going to be better. There's no numbers, though, so I can't tell. But I'm guessing Tau's going to be better. Oh, but it requires a Gravitino ball. And a little bit of microdensity. If there was a platinum around here, I would totally do it. But there isn't. So I think we just go for Tau and leave Theta to some other time. But where the heck would you get iron on this planet? I have never seen a planet devoid of iron resources before. Do these have iron resources? That's a bolt caster. That's not going to help me. That is iron, but a tiny, tiny, tiny amount of it. I mean, super small. Not even, like, really worth the time. Okay. There's got to be some deposit somewhere. Maybe I'm in the wrong place for it. Oh, great. I just dropped and damage my shield. That's a brilliant piece. What are you thinking? Okay, tell you what. We'll go So I think we should follow the ruin. And I'm tempted to walk it, but not without an iron resource. Without an iron resource, that's basically suicide. So we're not going to do it. But we can turn around and follow the ruin that way and see what it gets us. If the game crashes, I'm going to have to uninstall the portal mod. But if the game doesn't crash, we could actually see our first real portal here. Okay, so I have no idea where the heck iron would be. Where would it be? I have no idea. Oh, that looks like there's a depot over there. I can't tell whether or not that would be plasma, and I can't do my binoculars while I'm floating here. You know what? I can just look at it. I can just look at it. Just briefly. See what kind of resources that is. Because if it's platinum, I'm going to be all over that. That might actually be platinum. I mean, at least I can sell the location, right? So, I mean, obviously that won't give me as much as platinum will, but I'd still take it. So is it platinum? It's titanium. Damn it, damn it. I thought titanium was green. I thought the blue was indicating that it was platinum, but it's totally not. Okay, so never mind. Also, no iron deposits. This is the most barren rock I've ever seen. Maybe there's iron deposits up there? Maybe that's what those are? I mean, the only ones I see are the tiny iron deposits. I mean, they are all over the place, so that's something. Very, very little everywhere, I guess. Some zinc. That's good. Take platinum, too, if you got it. Just saying. I mean, I could do, like, some pulses there. Pick up some iron. I guess it's adding up a little bit. But yeah, these are such tiny little deposits. I'm expecting giant rocks. I guess this is the first planet that doesn't actually have that. Well, you got me, game. You surprised me. I actually did not expect you to have a variability on the amount of iron deposits. Oh, don't even complain about it, you silly monster. Calling him a monster, even though he probably actually isn't. Oh no, that might be an iron deposit down there. Maybe, possibly. I don't know, I'll make this start up. I have no idea. I'm desperate. Desperate for iron. Okay, there we go. There we go. That's a little better. Iron deposits are totally different on this world. Oh, there we go. Okay, good. That's at least something I can work with. That's some decent amount of iron there. Yeah, there we go. That just filled up a whole stack. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, good. So now, but no platinum, huh? I mean, I know I'm being greedy, but come on. A little bit of platinum? There's no blue symbols at all. I'm kind of curious what that trade good is, but it could just be, like, trade. There's another monolith over there. We can see if they point in the same direction. So yeah, we should probably move that over. And then what technology we want to use? We wanted to use coolant network tau, probably. Yeah, let's do tau, because he does the microdensity fabric. I mean, could we do theta? Needs electron vapor. What do we need to make electron vapor? Suspension fluid, right? Electron fluid. Yeah, let's actually do it. Let's do it. So electron vapor, and then we build out... Sorry, that's not what I meant to do. There we go. Cool network theta should do better. Uses up a gravitational ball, but it should be much better at it. And so now, hopefully it doesn't tick down very fast. And now we just need a bunch of iron deposits to make sure that works, and now we kind of know what iron deposits look like. So, yeah, I'm going to leave my ship behind. I realize it might be a mistake on a hot world, but maybe it'll be okay. And we know that the knights are at least... cool. Very little in the way of platinum around here. Or, not platinum. Well, yes, platinum too. But also plutonium. Looks like plutonium's only going to be inside caves. I can work with that. Possibly. If I find an entrance to a cave. I suppose I could just... burrow my way in. That works too. I'll just keep myself pulsed here. Okay, lots of knowledge stones around. You know what? For some reason I thought those were monoliths. They're totally not. They're knowledge stones. That's okay, I guess? Or do we want to follow the ruin? Could follow the ruin. Do we want to follow on foot? We're less likely to miss something, but we're more likely to take, you know, 2 million years. Maybe not 2 million. Oh, hey, platinum. Not expecting platinum there. Maybe not a whole 2 million, but, you know. Oh, it's one of those, isn't it? Yep, that's one of the tendril plants. It looks a little different than most of them, but still the same basic design. Oh, yeah, plutonium. I always forget how far the mining beam reaches. I always like getting really close, but that's really not necessary. Alright, and then just a little bit of iron just here and there. More platinum over there. Okay, we're learning like Gek words and Viking words. Is this like a planet that was, I don't know, fought over by both races? I have no idea. Yeah, let's go back to the ruin and follow it. Follow on foot or follow otherwise. Or follow by air. Don't even. Where's your other guy? Where's your other guy? There he is. Don't you hide from me. Don't you hide from me. What are you thinking? What are you thinking? And we go deep here. I mean, there's a bunch of iron down here. But mostly I'm interested in either platinum or a trade good. Either one would be fine. Boy, it's dense in here. What do you suppose a trade good would be in here? Well, I'm really hoping it's aluminum or nickel. I mean, I'll take either one of those, or maybe even copper, I think, shows up only in big deposits. I don't think it's going to show up with anything else. That is not what I want to do. I wanted to mine. Thank you. Okay, well, we're about to find out. We got plutonium and gold. Yes, gold. Oh, and we actually got a creature. Hello, little creature. You're an awful cute predator. You're an infant. Well, you are rather small. Still trying to defend your home, then. I appreciate that. Okay, so we should probably go back to the ship. Where the heck is the ship at? Ship is somewhere over the rainbow, far, far away. Yep, that way. Totally went the wrong way. Just don't let the little monsters eat you. That'd be an embarrassing way to go. Eaten by a tiny little... Tiny little beast, kind of like Nedry in Jurassic Park, the original. Actually, they haven't made a remake of that movie yet, have they? You know they're talking about it? Seems a little early for that, doesn't it? They're talking about doing a remake for Jurassic Park. It's like, man, that only came out in the 90s. And I realize there are people born today who can drive who weren't in the 90s, so there is that. But nevertheless, I mean... They only just did a remake of Magnificent Seven, and that was made in, I want to say, the 60s, but that might be actually later than it was. I think, wasn't Magnificent Seven, like, 50s? I don't remember. Anyway, they waited, what, 70, 80 years to do a remake to Magnificent Seven, but for some reason, they can only wait... maybe 20 years to do a remake of Jurassic Park. That doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. The monsters in Jurassic Park, and they are monsters, they're not really dinosaurs. But the monsters in Jurassic Park look really convincing. I mean, the way they did the CG and mixed it in with the practical effects, that was really, really impressive. Steven Spielberg knows his shit. And it's not going to be Spielberg doing the remake. So, I mean, that kind of makes sense. Does Spielberg already done it? Why would he do it again? So, I mean, it's like, you know, if George Lucas has decided that he wasn't going to do Star Wars prequels, he was going to pass it off, that would make a lot of sense to me. I think what we're seeing here is the... Oh, hello. You're creepy. You already discovered this. I don't remember that creature. I would have remembered something that creepy, I'm pretty sure. And apparently they're all over the damn place. They must be underground. And we're just... For some reason, they're aggroed on me now. I guess they got my scent. That's a little disturbing. We're gonna run away as far as fast as possible. Thank you. Okay, so we're gonna follow the ruin. So, the ruin? Yeah, I guess it's a ruin, not a monolith, huh? Oh, hello, big giant bat guys. Can't really see you guys too clearly, but as soon as I start uploading you... Oh, here we go. Maybe see him a little bit better. Okay, they're kind of cool. I like that. That's neat. They eat vegetation, in case you were wondering. Yeah, I realize I discovered this. That's the titanium. Okay, so, right, the monolith was, like, yeah, back over that way. Okay, so let's go back over that way and follow the monolith to the next monolith, assuming I have the direction correct. So, spin around. Right round, baby, right round. There we go. Okay, so, assuming I got the direction correct here. Okay, do we follow away from it? Like, away from the sphere or towards the sphere? Oh, so tough. So basically, like, that way, or do we go and turn around? Kind of seems like we would go this way, doesn't it? Seems like indicates going this way. That's what I choose to believe. We'll try it this way. And just, you know, pulse occasionally. See if you get any question marks. But remember, before, it seemed to be quite the distance between the ruins, monoliths, whatever you want to call them. I guess it's ruins if they give us a choice. It's monolith if they just give us words, I suppose. We'll see if this works. This is something. Well, no, it is not. I mean, it is kind of, it's a location. It's not a ruin. Full skin. There's another question mark over there. That kind of lines up with what I would expect. Assuming that I was a little bit off course. Scanner still recharging. There we go. Also, I don't see any... Oh, hold on. I was going to say I don't see any gold or anything, but no, that might be gold. Please tell me that's gold. Please tell me that's gold. Yes, it is gold. Okay, good. And iridium. Not that we need the iridium, but, you know, always good to have a little bit extra. We need to fill up a slot or something. Okay, so just land. Thank you. Okay, so yeah, we're definitely going to be coasting around this planet for a little while. Let's go to the question mark first, and then we can always return to the ship and mine out some gold as we need it. And that'll at least repair our theta. Oh, that is not a monolith. Okay, or a ruin for that matter. A lot of broken technology over here. We just pulse, so see all the blue markers. Huh. Okay, yeah, I mean, might as well. I don't think there's anything here we wanted to save, except I suppose just let it save the game, because why not? And just looking at the Atlas Pass stuff. Anything good? Suspension fluids, decent. Another one, so that actually helps us a little bit with creating some antimatter. Right, we need to create some... We're trying to create some dynamic resonators, weren't we? So, electron vapor. And another electron vapor. And stack those. Wasn't I doing this on the starship? I was doing this on the starship. Okay, yeah, move that over. Okay, back to the starship. Yeah, so now it's going to be nighttime, so those are going to... Everything's going to stabilize now. So, antimatter. Okay, so. I just need two more dynamic resonators. Requires microdensity fabric plus 4. I have 2 of them. 1, 2 more. It's the dynamic resonator now. Good. That's 4 of them. I just need 5. So that means microdensity fabric, right? And 1 more antimatter. I can do that probably. Suspension fluid, electron vapor, antimatter. There you go. And then microdensity fabric, I need 4 of those, is that right? I can never remember the recipe. This is why when I cook, I always have the recipe out in front of me at all times. Then I look at it whenever I have a question. There we go. We can totally do this. Just stack that. Then build the diamond resonator. There we go. Perfect. Used up all the antimatter we had, but big freaking deal. Okay, so now we have enough to create all three, theoretically. So now we just need the raw materials. Okay, but there should be gold in them thar hills. And we're going to be mining at night, which means it's not going to eat through our shield. And we have the top level shield, which should take less time to recharge. Or less time, sorry, not less time, more time to deplete, is what I mean to say. Okay, so big old chunk of rock right over there. 81% of our mining beam. We have decent amount of plutonium to charge it. So I think we can just go ahead and just wipe it off the face of the planet. A little bit of platinum. Can't say no to platinum. Thank you. And then let's just go ahead and mine out this entire thing. Oh, right. Gold's not very dense. I forgot about that. Yeah, so it's going to take a while. How much gold do we need? Like 500. And there's a monster. Go away, monster. I don't want you here. Oh, don't even complain about it. You know what? You can say that, but tough. Oh, really? Really? You're going to fight me for this? I'll fight you for this. I don't care. Oh, hold up. I need to reload. That's okay. You're bad at this anyway. Yeah. Want to shoot somebody? Shoot somebody. Don't talk about it. What is that a quote from? That is a quote from one of the Man with No Name movies. It's funny, they haven't talked about, at least I don't know they've talked about, ever remaking the Clint Eastwood films. And I guess, I mean, spaghetti westerns are kind of like in their own little area of, it's like, well, I mean, except for the Magnificent Seven, I suppose. That kind of spaghetti western? Maybe. Maybe it does. Maybe it's an attempt. They're going, well, you know, if it works for Magnificent Seven, maybe it'll work for, I don't know, Man with No Name? Fistful of Dollars? $2 more? I forget what the other one are. Something like that, though. All pretty good movies. But yeah, so far, no sign of a remake. For better or for worse, who would you get to do that? Who's the Western star now? I don't know. I mean, I suppose Clinton didn't just do Westerns, but he's known for Westerns. But I suppose, I mean, Dirty Harry movies is really what he's known for, right? I mean, that and being, like, a big Western guy. Okay, I think we pretty much took all the gold out of it. Oh, no, we didn't. There's still a little bit more. Take as much as we can before we leave this deposit. Because it's not very dense. It's only giving us 2 per burst. But I suppose the iridium was doing that too. Oh, yeah, there's a whole little, like, kind of weird piece going on here. I'll take what we can get. I still have a wanted level of 1. How is that possible? There's no... Yeah, there's nobody here. There's no signal indicating that... Indicating that they're anywhere near me. So what the hell? How do I still have a wanted level? Did I miss something? Is there a beast around here somewhere? Is it because I killed a beast and they're like, well, that's just unforgivable? Be kinda silly. That hasn't happened before. Doesn't necessarily mean it's not happening now, though. Yeah, but we still have a wanted level of 1. That is very strange. I don't get it at all. Well, I suppose worst comes to worst, we can always go into a manufacturing facility or operation center or something like that. And, then clear it out that way. I thought... Okay, you know what? I might need the torch for this. There we go. That's what I wanted. That one little thing had 2 things of iridium for it, so... I don't know. Was it worth it? You tell me. There we go. Okay, so gold. I want gold. I don't want to kill any more beasts if I can avoid it. I already have a 1 level of 1. Who knows what killing another one will do. What about if... Well, so the thing is, I don't know if I went in the right direction. So if I didn't go in the right direction, then there's not going to be a ruin directly ahead of me. I mean, assuming it's directly that way. If I did go in the right direction, then it's possible I just haven't hit it yet. There was quite the long distance between ruins, if I remember correctly.
What to do, what to do? I mean, I'm tempted to go on foot. That would guarantee that I don't miss it.
That's assuming I'm going in the right direction in the first place. Otherwise, I'm just kind of wildly roaming, and I mean, that's okay too, but not exactly what I signed up for. Yeah, so we're going towards the big thing of gold. Assuming that is an emerald over there, which would be pretty funny, but I don't think it is. Okay, so this should let us repair. I was like, is this going to be enough? How much gold do we have right now? Gold, 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 gold. Oh, I'm looking at the starship. No wonder I can't find it. Okay, so yeah, we just need a little bit. Actually, this might do it, maybe? Assuming we're getting like 150 gold per rock, or per boulder here, then yes. If not, though, we might need another one. I have a feeling that we're going to need another one. I don't know what I'm basing that feeling on. It's just a hunch. If only gold was this easy to pick up in real life, you know? Oh yeah, you want gold? It's over there, in the gold rock. Oh, well, that's handy. Yeah, it's all nicely, you know, purified for you and everything. I mean, it's probably not actually purified. There's a lot of rubble going on here. So this beam is doing something magical to the rock. It's basically pulling only the pure metal out, but leaving whatever impurities behind. So that's a neat trick. There's a lot of miners throughout history who wish they had that kind of trick. Like, there's a lot of miners in current day who wish they had that kind of trick. Taking the impurities out of metal is really annoying and a long and laborious process. If there was a way to simply do it as fast as we're doing now, that'd be fantastic. It would save a lot of work. Okay, there's another gold deposit like directly ahead of us, so that's simple enough. That beast has supposedly been on our tail, but refuses to eat us, so I'm gonna guess for some reason he can't get to us. Either he's below ground, or he's run up against a rock and has just decided to charge the rock instead of us. It's really hard to tell which. I'm gonna guess below ground. How does he even know we're here? He heard a footsteps. It's like Tremors all over again. I haven't watched Tremors in forever. I remember being terrified of it as a kid. Did those ships just come in super low and... What jerks? What jerks? He could have hit me and killed me. That would have been a horrible way to die. How'd you die? Oh, well, you know, some people came by because they thought it'd be funny and, shoot, what is even the term? Dive bombed, I suppose? Guess. Okay, so let's see. That should be enough gold. So let's go over to the starship. We're gonna have to transfer it over, aren't we? I don't think so. I think we just hit repair. Kaboom! Yep, done. Okay, that was easy. Let's move the chrysonite down because we're going to need that room. Okay, so now we want to build the other one. So we don't need gold anymore. What do I need? I need nickel, I need aluminum. And copper. Copper would be ideal. Are we even going to find any copper on this planet? I have no idea. So we can sell all the gold we have now. It's not even needed. Copper. So copper usually manifests as giant floating rocks. 9/10 of the time, that's what you see copper as. I have never seen copper as spikes on the ground like we see with plutonium or crystallite or whatever the hell the thing is called. So that's never happened. Doesn't mean it won't, just I've never seen it. So then, this planet might not have any copper. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. Meaning, with one of them repaired, I think we can totally say we can go ahead and move to the Narc star system and just trust that that's going to have copper. What we're going to do first is try to follow to the ruins and maybe take a portal. We take a portal that's, I think, guaranteed to take us closer to the center of the galaxy, which is our overall goal. Okay, good. Cleared up a little bit. That's all I wanted. And then we'll go ahead and look at these question marks. One of these should be a ruin, I believe. I'm guessing it's going to be the one in front of us, because I think the one over there is a trade depot. Am I right? Not just a signal analyzer. Nothing else. Okay. That is not a ruin. That is a depot. Which I believe that is all titanium. Well, whoop-de-frickin'-do for you. Okay, so that's not going to work. Pulse again. See, like, that place, why isn't that place showing up as a question mark? Because it doesn't have a save point, actually. Okay, that's weird. So there are points that don't have save points, but exist nevertheless. So I've probably been missing those the whole time. Didn't even realize that was a thing. Okay, almost hit the birds. Whatever you want to call them. I thought for a second that was a thing of copper. That would have been beautiful, but it's not. I mean, that's another signal analyzer. No ruins, huh? I might have picked the wrong direction. Does that mean we swing back? Maybe? I think it would be in this direction. I kind of swerved a lot, though, but I thought I kept true to the course. Maybe I didn't. Maybe I didn't. What is that? That looked like a knowledge. That looked like a monolith, actually. Yes. Yes, it is. And actually, it's pointing that way. It's pointing, like, almost directly that way. So let's see if we can land, like, over this way. It actually let me land. It buried the cockpit in the rock, but who cares? Okay, and there is a question mark now that I'm on the ground. I wonder if maybe the problem we're having is that I'm either too low, which would be kind of funny, or if I'm just moving too fast. And so it's not able to pull up the proper question marks for everything. Proper markers, really, is what I actually mean to say. Sentinels are the enemy of progress and civilization. They are not of the natural order. The interference is a front to the virtuous Viking crusade. It seeks to balance all things through blood, ashes, and iron. I prefer the Oxford comma, though, to blood, ashes, and iron. Just saying. Okay. Seek help with language, yada, yada, yada. Viking increases. Word for beak, which is interesting because they don't actually have a beak. But I'm sure they're talking about the Gek when they talk about beaks. Though not all Gek seem to have beaks. There's a lot of dimorphism going on with species, which you can really expect in a galactic empire. I mean, even if it is all was all based on the same species, you can expect some serious divergence. Okay, so we need to go, like, I don't know, 10 to 15 degrees to the right, and I think we'll be facing the correct direction. Okay, that's what I'm going to go with. 10 to 15 degrees to the right, which might even be like that question mark, but that seems a little short. It's possible, but okay, not actually possible. That was the trade depot. Okay, so I think it's like this way. So I'm going to... Yeah, see, like that one doesn't have a question mark. But again, it doesn't have a beacon, so I think that's expected. That also doesn't have... Well, that does have a question mark, but it's not a ruin. I mean, I don't know actually what to expect. I don't know if I should be actually... If it just follows, like, ruin to ruin to ruin, and they just go around in a big circle. Or if it actually does lead to a portal, and it's just... We've been just unlucky. We haven't found any portals yet. I could see either one being true. That is a depot, which is fair, but not exactly what I'm looking for. Just keep pulsing. Just keep pulsing. Cool cave systems that we see here. I kind of wish they all interconnected, but I guess that'd be a little silly. Okay, wait, there's a ruin right here, which we kind of followed to the right place. I mean, we were on a standard deviation, I think. That makes the most sense. What's a good place to land? That's a good question. So I think... Okay, let's full stop. So what I think is if we don't land, that's fine. Although I kind of missed the 3 or 4 pieces of language we pick up. This is not the one we did before, is it? No, because the knowledge stones haven't been activated. Okay. So I think I think we followed it backwards last time. Or not backwards. No. We did it right. So what I'm thinking is that this diagonal makes a kind of arrow, and so we want to follow the arrow. So that means that we want to go that way, more or less. Now the trouble is lining this up properly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to loop around until I find you again. Where are you? There you are. Okay, so yeah, let's loop around a little bit so that I get into a proper location. And we hit the birds. Don't hit the birds. Okay, so yeah, just straight away from this little trade area here, and then turn around. I probably don't need to keep full speed as I turn around, but I like the feeling of it. And then pulse again, because that should have been a question mark, right? But for some reason, it's not. That's what I don't get. Why are some of these question marks and others of these aren't? Okay, so I'm pretty sure... Hold up. We need to go that way. The trouble is landing at a more or less flat space, and I think now? Nope, not gonna do it. Okay. You know what? We don't have to land, but I really would miss out on those beautiful, beautiful words in whatever language it is. I would guess Viking. Okay, we're down pretty deep here, but that's okay. Oh, see, now it has a question mark. I am so confused. The ship-based pulse doesn't seem to work as well. But is my imagination, or was that actually faster than last time? Which means maybe we missed one. So I'm really tempted to walk, because by walking we'll make sure we don't miss one. However, if we have another crash to desktop, it means we're doomed, because I'm not sure it saves. Yeah, oh, actually we've tested that, right? It doesn't save after we hit the ruin. It only saves after we either exit the ship or we actually hit a beacon and save. So what that would mean is directly just following our nose, not going any other direction but forward, not hitting any knowledge stones we find, not hitting anything else, just walking forward in a straight line. That seems almost impossible. On the upside, we won't miss on too many words, theoretically. Well, it depends on how far it is, right? I mean, knowledge stones seem to be pretty close together here. So if we were to do that, yeah, we might miss out on quite a few words. Alright, so we're gonna, I mean, obviously, we've never been here before. It just looked very similar to the other design. Okay, small terrified creature emerges from the monolith, runs between the legs. Howl of pack animals in pursuit and thunder of hooves. Warriors on vast beasts charge to the rocket and miss the chaos once he's me staring. It raises facial tendrils in greeting, barks a few words, and swings a bladed weapon down towards me. So, Viking Ancients Bless. You know what? Dodging, I don't think they'd appreciate. I think they'd appreciate me grabbing it. Yep, transforms in multi-tool I can use. Okay, that was right. Hopefully it's better than the one we have, or at least has more slots. I guess that means we have to rebuild it from scratch. Oh, but it's very colorful. 18 slots. Yeah, it's definitely better. There's no synergy. Well, very little synergy in the way they have this set up. You know what? I'm going to take it. It's going to be colorful. But yeah, 18 slots is better than what we currently have. It just means we have to build it up again. That's totally fine. Yeah, that should be totally fine. Let's do it. Sorry, decline there by an automatic, I don't know. So let's compare it. But I'm pretty sure, yeah, ours is currently better in every respect right now. Mostly because of synergies. But with more slots, we get more synergies. And we're almost full out in slots anyway. If I had the room, I would definitely be doing more techs, I think. So I'd be doing not only Taos, but maybe also Sigmas. I mean, a plus 2 and a plus 1 basically equals a plus 3, right? So, I mean, I don't actually know if that's true. It does in math-wise, but I don't know if it does in No Man's Skyland. So, yeah, let's do it. I'm just looking to make sure, but yeah, the trouble is I can't disassemble the current stuff, which means we just lose it. But we're able to disable the stuff here for the new multi-tool, so good enough. Let's take it. It's all nice and colorful now, so that's cool. Oh, is my exosuit stuff run out? No, it's not run out yet. Okay, it's just showing me stuff. Okay, we also got a Viking effigy. I don't remember seeing that before. Okay, so we want to take off. We want to take off a lot of this stuff. So this all gets synergy with itself, which helps a little bit, but not as much as if it was all one thing. So what I think we do is we disassemble the plasma launcher and put it like over here. We disassemble the scanner, like put it on the edges and then build your way towards the center. I think would be the smart way to do this. So the mining beam has to stay. Has to stay there. That's just how it works. Combat amplifier is totally fine. But yeah, the plasma launcher goes away. We're going to move that over here. So we can install the tech for the plasma launcher. Maybe? Yeah, there we go. There we go. Plasma launcher is set there. And then the bolt caster we're going to put up here, right? So let's get rid of... Oh, what about the scanner, though? Yeah, see, this plan requires four edges. I don't have four edges. I guess I do technically. Because the scanner could stay there. I disassemble that. I mean, I'd miss the coolant, don't get me wrong, but I think I'll get enough of it that I'll be able to build one of the coolants. So yeah, then we make like the range boost sigma in here, or theta, you know, whatever, and push it here. So let's do that. And that'll give us some synergy where we want it. And we can make the bolt caster over on this side, which is good. And then, yeah, let's make the scanner tech. Oh, analysis visor. Yeah, we kind of need that, don't we? We need the analysis visor. And there we go. So that's all lined up. Range boost tau is actually totally fine. I don't think theta is going to do much better. Actually, if tau is 3... Okay, now I'm starting to doubt myself. That's only sigma. So we don't actually know range boost theta. That's surprising. Range boost theta not exist? I'm really puzzled now. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Do impact damage plus 2, I guess. What is this? Added physical damage upon contact. I don't know why it's called SM. But sure. And then give the other one for the impact. Yeah, impact damage plus 2. There we go. And then the plasma launcher with the grenade. Give me the damage radius, I suppose, or do I want the other one? Oh, I can't do the intensity right now. I guess it ate up the neutrino modules, and now I don't have any left. Well, that's a shame. I definitely don't want rebound grenades. That sounds like a horrible idea. But yeah, a little bit of damage radius, absolutely. That's combat amplifier. If we can also do a couple of things for gems. Beam coolant plus 1 is okay. I'd really like the beam coolant plus 3. What does that require? More aluminum and more heridium. Okay, well, at the very least, we can do, like, beam focus and beam coolant. Let's do beam focus. No, let's do beam coolant first. And then beam focus. Okay, and then beam intensifier doesn't matter, because that's just terrain destruction. Okay, so if we have another scanner, we can put it here. If not, then we can build out that with bullcaster, and then this out here can either go to, yeah, that can be like the damage intensity, and we build the beams out here. That works. Okay, so we go, I guess we go in this direction. The ship's more or less pointed that way. I'm not going to walk. I'm tempted to, but the we just got a journey milestone accomplished. What do you know? I think that actually finishes up. Oh, that's the Viking standing. That's weird. We've been in a special relationship with the Viking for, like, I don't know, 20 episodes? I suppose. I don't know what to suppose. Actually, I'm really confused what the heck. Why we got that journey accomplishment just then. Is the game just now catching up that we have a special relationship? We're also in a special relationship with the Gek and the other race whose name I forget, which I guess means we're not all that special, but that's really, really peculiar. But okay, game, I'll believe you. I thought for a second there it was going to say that, you know, we'd walked 1,000 steps or whatever, but apparently not. Oh, okay, yeah, we do need some from Heridium, don't we? Oh, it's a purple beam, and that's yellow again. Okay. But yeah, we do need some Heridium, so I'll take some Heridium. Coolant is definitely working. That's good. Yeah, I'm not going to walk. The fact that there's a storm going on, I mean, not necessarily a horrible, horrible thing, but it is going to take us forever to walk to the next ruin. Could I maybe... I wonder if maybe I just keep walking. It says end the episode now, and just keep walking, and then tell you guys when I reach a portal. That way, if the game crashes, it doesn't impact the episode any, and you guys still get to see a portal, theoretically. If the game does crash, then I'll just come back here to this save and tell you guys, well, sorry guys, but the portal mod made my game crash and I can't use it. And then I'll deinstall the portal mod, and then we never have to worry about it again. But either way, yeah, I mean, that makes it a little dull for me, but, well, you know what, I'll just listen to like a YouTube video or something and, you know, do the same thing you're doing right now, probably as you're going through. So yeah, I will totally do that and walk my way to the next ruin, which I believe is pointed this way. According to that, if I line it up properly, that's the real trick, right? I want to go straight that way, I believe. And I'll pulse occasionally to make sure I'm on the right path, but I think that should do it. So right, let's go ahead and just save inside the ship so I know where we are. And then pop out again. Okay, good. That saved us. Alright, so yeah, next time I see you guys, I will be either in front of a ruin or right here. It depends. So, thank you guys for watching. This has been No Man's Sky. I'm PC Universe, you're PC Universe 2, and I'll see you guys next time.